guys, I'm Meg from PMTVUK.
And I'm Dagan.
And we are in sunny California. We are over here visiting some brands and some factories, but we got a bit of a day off today, so we thought we'd do a vlog in Hollywood.
Yeah, we thought, because we were going to come here anyways, and when you come to California, Hollywood, you have to check out the Sunset Strip. I adore 80s rock and metal music, and that was born on this strip. So we're going to have a little bit of a tour, check out Guitar Center, the Hollywood Walk of Fame, and some little musical pieces of interest. Like maybe later on, we'll go to the Whiskey A Go-Go,
Yeah. The
Troubadour, the Rainbow. Well, we've already been to the Rainbow, and you drank too much, and you got a little bit of a hangover today, but let's not dwell on that. Let's go to our first place, which is Guitar Center, because it's like a museum, isn't it?
Yes.
As well as just a guitar store. Like, PMT is the biggest guitar store in the UK. So many stores over here, it's Guitar Center. It's amazing, even though they do spell center wrong. Let's do it. If you're in Hollywood, the place to come to buy guitars is Guitar Center. And I was joking about center before, we just spell it slightly different
Yeah. In
England, don't we? But everyone from Joe Bonamassa, John Mayer, all the big stars to people just starting out in pubs and clubs in Hollywood, all buy the guitars from here. And you can't miss it, can you, Meg?
No, you really can't.
Or even the Hollywood bus tours come past here and show Guitar Center. It's that iconic. So you're drawn outside by the amazing artwork. You've got Hendrix up top here. I say it's very colourful, it's very beautiful. It's just fantastic, and it only gets better when you walk inside, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
But even before we get to inside, let's check out the Rock Walk and put our hands in some famous hands and some feet. So Guitar Center came about in 1959, which was also the ever very popular Les Paul, Yeah. Which has passed through these doors so many times. A chap called Wayne Mitchell bought a store which sold organs and vacuums. And it was originally called the Organ Center. And then I think to keep selling the organs, he had to get some amplifiers in. And those amps were called Vox.
Ah.
And then it was the Vox Center. And this was back in the 60s where the British invasion kind of happened, where it was all Yeah. Vox. It was all Rolling Stones, all Vox, all Oasis, no, Beatles.
Beatles.
It's very overwhelming here. Beatles and the Rolling Stones, so the invasion kind of happened. Sold some Voxes, and then all of a sudden more guitars came through the door. Marshall happened, and then it became Guitar Center. And it's always been based in Hollywood, California. This is the amazing, I don't think it was actually originally here, I think it was somewhere else, but this is 1985. This place came about, I think, and on the floor in 1985, the Rock Walk came about. Now these are, well, handprints of some of the most iconic people in music history. Everyone knows the Hollywood one where everyone writes their names in and stuff, like Marilyn Monroe Yeah. And stuff. This is for the rock and roll fans. So these are for the people who have left a lasting mark on the music industry, as well as some guitars on the outside, which we'll talk about shortly, but who have you seen that you enjoy, Meg?
Oh, honestly, there's just about everyone you could think of. I did spot Stephen Stills up the top from Crosby, Stills and Nash.
Very nice.
Stevie Wonder right there.
There's some really quirky ones as well. Everyone knows Angus Young's tiny. He's got tiny little hands.
Yeah.
Lemmy's put his middle finger in. The drummer from Def Leppard only has one arm, so he's put his foot in it. There's Brian May's foot up there as well. There's AC/DC. There's, of course, Eddie Van Halen. There's Guns N' Roses. There's everyone that you can imagine. It's an amazing thing just to come up and go like, how big's my hand compared to Eddie Van Halen's hand? Slightly bigger, but I think he might have the edge on the guitar playing. There's Les Paul there as well. Jimmy Page, Jeff Beck, Steve Vai. Steve Vai's massive. Look how big Steve Vai's hands are.
Wow.
Put your hand in Steve Vai's hand. That's amazing. He's actually got six fingers on his hand in the imprint. Billy Gibbons has a slide cemented in his hand as well. The more you look, the more you can miss so much, you've got to really study it. But it's not just the stuff on the floor, is it, Meg?
No, yeah, I don't know if you can see behind us, but they've also got up on the wall for all the people that would have passed away before this. They've immortalised them on the plaques. So there's Hendrix, John Lennon, Marvin Gaye.
Got Elvis, I see Ray Vaughan, Jaco Pastorius, obviously Dimebag. Immortalised as well, these beautiful guitars behind us. One of the newest ones is cool to see, Nita Strauss. I saw Nita Strauss done it at her new Ibanez Jiva. We've got Ronnie Wood. Who else have we got down there, Meg?
Oh, Flea Bass, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Santana, very nice.
Bobby Neal, Melissa Etheridge's Ovation. That's a tongue twister right there. Slash back here, signed Jimmy Page guitar. Michael Anthony from Van Halen, Chicken Foot, and there's more over here.
BB King's Lucille, St. Vincent.
Yeah, cool St. Vincent Music Man there. The Kirk Hammett one's cool. It's obviously a Dean ML adorned with lots of dimes. In tribute for Dimebag, it's very, very cool. Got the Lucite bass there, Geezer Butler from Black Sabbath, Orianthe has a signed PRS over there, and at the back here, Mrs. Zach Wilde as well, obviously Zach's got a lovely Les Paul custom. The back here, we have one of the replicas of Eddie Van Halen's favourite Frankenstein, so you can get the Frankie now, but this is one of the expensive, I think they're like 25 grand.
Wow.
When these were released in the mid-2000s, all signed off by Eddie, and it's as close as you can get to the real thing. And the real thing, 5150 Studios, isn't even that far away from here, so I'm kind of losing my mind right now. This place is very intense. And this is before we even get inside. Now, we're out here in Hollywood shooting with all of our favourite brands here at PMT, like ESP, Schecter and Taylor and stuff, but what I wanted to do more than anything was to come and check out the Eddie mural at the back of Guitar Center. Edward Van Halen meant the world to me as a musician, as a guitar player, as a songwriter. He's an absolute legend, and the reason that I pretty much play guitar and enjoy playing music and therefore have this job. This was unveiled onto the world on Eddie, what would have been Eddie's 66th birthday, so January 26, 2021. And it's just a masterpiece. It's 17 feet tall, it's 105 feet wide. Robert Vargas has done an amazing job of this. It's called Long Live the King. He was a huge Eddie fan, and I'm a huge Eddie fan. Wolfgang was here when it was released, unveiled, and it's just an absolute masterpiece. So much so that this year, 2022, on what would have been Ed's 67th birthday, they've made it augmented reality. So you can download an app on your phone and put it up to this, and then while Eruption's playing in the background, of course it is, and Eddie, his fingers move, there's flames, there's fireworks. It's just absolutely amazing, and yeah, I'm gonna just stand and take it in for a little while. Joining me all the way to the west, where the beaches are glorious, the sea and the skies are blue. We're of course on Venice Beach, one of the most famous seafronts on the entire planet. Now, this street is famous for self-expression and free speech, and you will find some of the most amazing buskers you've ever seen on this street. It's a creative hub. It makes musicians kind of buzz when you walk along a street like this. It gets all the juices flowing. It's fantastic. So these buskers are amazing, but you also find magicians and belly dancers, all while it's kind of weave your way around skateboarders and rollerbladers. But besides music, you can buy a vintage Led Zeppelin t-shirt and Aerosmith. You can buy some Greek food. There's even a guy down there selling shit advice for a dollar.
There are so many famous songs written about this part of LA from every music genre you can possibly imagine. But a big one that you might know about, this is where Jim Morrison met Ray Manzarek in July 1965. And together they formed a little band you might know called The Doors. You also might recognize this spot as a place where the Red Hot Chili Peppers did a live video in 2011 for Rain Dance Maggie. They actually filmed it up on a rooftop over there just by Venice Beach.
So if you're a Doors fan, you've just got to get yourself to Venice Beach. It's unbelievable. There's the places where Jim Morrison used to play guitar, read live poetry, and of course, like Med said, where they all met and where they stayed in hotels around here. But even if you're not a Doors fan, the electricity in the air is just it's just crazy around here. It gets the creative juices flowing. So get yourself to Venice Beach, and I guarantee as soon as you get back to your beautiful guitar, you'll be learning to write some amazing songs about this beautiful place.
So we thought we'd end the vlog on one of the most iconic streets in the whole of LA, of course, Hollywood Boulevard. The whole street is paved with stars, musicians, movie stars, CGI characters, Mickey Mouse is just on the floor here, even Godzilla. If you are a musician, a performer, an artist, then this is definitely a spot you have to get yourself down to. It is iconic.
As with the rest of this vlog and just Hollywood in general, the electricity is in the air, and you just have to get yourself here as a musician or even as a creative person. Even if you're not even creative, this will make you just want to do something because there's so much buzz happening all around this place. It's absolutely crazy. One of my favorite places to visit, besides just even checking out the stars on the floor, is the Hard Rock Cafe in Hollywood. This is probably one of the biggest ones, if not the biggest or the most impressive in the world, because there's a little stage downstairs as well, and many famous bands play there. I suppose Guns N' Roses is quite a lot on this whole little series, but loads of bands play downstairs in here, as well as seeing all these celebrity guitars, and they're all on the wall. You've got Dave Navarro, Slash, amongst a plethora of other iconic guitar players. And speaking of iconic venues and places to check out, we have a whole separate series, because I'd love to talk about Sunset Strip on this little thing right now, but we have a whole separate series coming out in our iconic venue series, which is coming very, very soon, where we check out the entirety of Sunset Strip and go in depth of all the venues, which I personally love and really wanted to get my teeth into on this little trip to Hollywood. But besides, they got the Fonda Theatre down the road as well, which is fantastic. There's the Grammy Museum, which you just have to check out. And even right now, when we're filming this, it's quite late on, and they're getting ready. There's loads of truss and metal lights and stuff, because there's a movie premiere here tomorrow at the Chinese Theatre, which is a theatre where we spoke about the Rock Walk earlier on, the Rock Walk earlier on outside Guitar Centre, where there's the hands of Eddie Van Halen and Steve Vai and Les Paul and all those guys. Up there, the Chinese Theatre, there's Marilyn Monroe, there's Clint Eastwood, there's so many amazing people up there. It's, yeah, the Rock Walk of Fame is a homage to that, but yeah, it's cool. There's the Dolby Theatre as well, which is where the Oscars have been held since 2001. I think all in this tiny little stretch of beautiful neon loveliness. It's a spectacle, man. One of the coolest places even just to check out when you're here is Jimmy Kimmel Live. You can't really see much from the outside, but everyone's seen the TV show, and at the back is the live stage.
Yeah.
Where so many amazing artists play my favorite one recently is Sam Fender. Yeah, he played there, and I'm so bloody jealous because he's a local lad to me in Newcastle. But yeah, it's a spectacle, like I keep saying. What's your favorite star you've seen on the deck?
Oh, I've seen a few. I clocked the Doors over there. That was pretty cool. Fleetwood Mac.
You're quite taken by Mickey Mouse.
I was quite taken by Mickey Mouse. Bit of a rogue one too. I quite like the Ricky Martin one.
Who doesn't love a bit of Ricky Martin?
Right.
Mine's pretty self-explanatory. I have Motley Crue, Guns N' Roses. It is what it is, but you'd be surprised how long this stretch actually goes of stars, because this is the main bit of Hollywood Boulevard, as you can see from all the lights and stuff. But it goes blocks and blocks that way. So even past shops which aren't necessarily covered in the glitz and glamour of Hollywood, there's still the stars on the floor. It's quite a thing to behold. It's very cool. And Sting, another local lad. Go on, Sting. Who wants that? I'm just getting distracted now. Keep rolling, because it'll be fun for me to just deeks at folk on the floor. Chris Pratt. Love a bit of Chris Pratt.
Phil Collins.
Paul Rudd. Phil Collins.
Oh, Paul Rudd. How good is Paul Rudd?
Paul Rudd is excellent. Right, anyways. Next. One more thing to say, which I really love about this street as well, is the fact that it honours, besides the stars on the floor, our past heroes and icons that we love. And they've got Madame Tussauds up there and the Hollywood Wax Museum, and a lot of my icons and heroes, and I know some of yours as well, unfortunately passed away. This is a great opportunity to, I don't know, get up close and personal and kind of appreciate as if you were there backstage or at a VIP thing. It's really, really cool, isn't it?
Absolutely. Honestly, I think this is my first time in Hollywood. There is so much to see here, you can't even do it in one trip. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you can catch all of our videos from this LA trip. It has been so much fun. I hope you enjoy it as much as we have.
It's been a lot of fun, yeah. I mean, this is technically one of our days off here, but we couldn't go to all these places and not kind of film it and share it with you guys. So please comment down below your favorite bits and expand on anything that we haven't spoken about, because this is going to be a longish video as it is. We can't fit the whole of LA into one little video here at PMTVUK. So please comment down below what you want to say and share the love about this amazing city, this amazing place. And yeah, like Mike said, thank you so much for watching. Cheers.